Hello and welcome to Watching Indie TV. I'm Vedant Agarwal. Our lead story, well, the big exclusive with Prime Minister Narendra Modi on the campaign trail in Patna. My colleague Mara Shakil caught up with the Prime Minister. He spoke at length about the BJP's Look East policy and also his assessment of Bihar and the rest of the country. Take a look.
He is the tallest mass leader that India has seen in many decades. Prime Minister Narendra Modi is today in Pataliputra. And in this epic battle, he has decided to give us time amidst his busy schedule. Pradhan Mantri ji, NDTV ke darshakon ke liye baat karne ke liye bahut bahut shukriya. Hamare 6 channels ke jo viewers hain, wo abhi aapko dekh rahe hain. Aapne desh bhar mein karyakram kiya. पटना की वाइब्स क्या कुछ अलग है?
हिंदुस्तान के करीब करीब सभी राज्यों में मेरा जाना हुआ और मैं कह सकता हूं पूरे देश में भारतीय जनता पार्टी और एनडीए को 400 पार कराने का दृढ़ संकल्प है। बिहार ने भी उसमें कई नए रंग भरे हैं, बिहार ने उसमें एक नई ताकत दी और इस प्रकार से ये अपने आप में पूरे देश का जो माहौल है वही माहौल बिहार का है।
प्रधानमंत्री जी, बहुत सारे आंकलन लगाए जा रहे हैं कि जो ईस्ट इंडिया है वहां पे बीजेपी का अपस्विंग है। आप बंगाल की बात कर लें या फिर उड़ीसा की, आंध्र प्रदेश और तेलंगाना में भी, तो आपका क्या असेसमेंट है?
एक तो राजनीति के अलावा अगर मैं कहूँ तो शायद मेरा 2013 का भाषण है और तब मैं पीएम कैंडिडेट भी नहीं था कि भारत का विकास करना है तो हमें पूर्वी भारत को विकसित करना चाहिए, पूर्वी भारत को ग्रोथ इंजन बनाना चाहिए। पिछले 10 साल में मैंने लगातार हिंदुस्तान के पूर्वी भारत में इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर, एजुकेशन, हेल्थ, ऐसे हर प्रोजेक्ट पर बल दिया है। इस चुनाव का जहां तक सवाल है, जबरदस्त आंधी उत्तर दक्षिण पूर्व पश्चिम सब दूर है। पूर्व में इस बार परिणाम ज्यादा मिलेंगे पहले की तुलना में और मैं मानता हूं देश के लोगों के लिए ये चौंकाने वाले, जैसे तेलंगाना आप कल्पना नहीं कर सकते वैसा परिणाम तेलंगाना में मिलेगा, वैसा आंध्र में मिलेगा, वैसा उड़ीसा में मिलेगा, वैसा बंगाल में मिलेगा, पूर्वी भारत में मिलेगा, बिहार हो, झारखंड हो, असम हो। यानी एक प्रकार से मैं देख सकता हूं कि चुनाव में भारतीय जनता पार्टी के पास जो है उसमें कई नए एरिया अधिक प्लस करेंगे।
ये कैचमेंट एरियाज की आप बात कर रहे हैं, प्रधानमंत्री जी बिहार का आकलन करिए, क्या लग रहा है बिहार में क्या होगा?
बिहार में हमारे साथियों से मेरी बात हुई, पहले हमारी एक सीट हम हारे थे, शायद इस बार हम एक भी नहीं हारेंगे।
अभी हम जहां पे खड़े हैं वो चरखा समिति के पास हैं हम। आप बताइए, जब आप आते हैं बिहार तो आपको क्या क्या ख्याल आता है?
वैसे मैं संगठन के काम के लिए यहां बहुत आया हूं, अनेक क्षेत्रों में मैं गया हूं, और मैं काफी पुरानी चीजों से जुड़ा हुआ रहा हूँ यहाँ।
आप इस चुनाव को रेफरेंडम के तौर पे देखते हैं या गवर्नेंस मॉडल की लड़ाई देखते हैं?
भारतीय जनता पार्टी ने देश को एक गवर्नेंस का मॉडल दिया है, देश ने कांग्रेस का मॉडल देखा है, देश ने लेफ्ट का मॉडल देखा है, देश ने मिलीजुली सरकारों का मॉडल देखा है और देश ने पूर्ण बहुमत वाले भाजपा एनडीए का मॉडल देखा है। और वह गतिशील सरकार देखी है, निर्णायक सरकार देखी है, रिस्क लेने वाली सरकार देखी है और उसके आधार पर हम आगे बढ़ रहे हैं।
प्रधानमंत्री जी, महिलाओं की संख्या वहां पर बहुत है, महिला वोटर, आपने एक कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंसी बनाई अपने लिए क्योंकि जो जो आपने किया, इज्जत घर दिया, उज्ज्वला योजना, बहुत सारे राज्य में भी महिला सेंट्रिक स्कीम है, तो आपको लगता है वो महिला वोटर आपके साथ?
एम्पावरमेंट ऑफ वीमेन, ये मेरा कमिटमेंट है और मैंने G20 समिट में एक लीड लिया है विमेन लेड डेवलपमेंट, और इसके लिए हमें महिलाओं को अवसर देना चाहिए। परंपरागत हमारी जो चीजों में महिलाओं को जोड़ते हैं उससे ऊपर उठना चाहिए। जैसे हमने गांव में ड्रोन दीदी बनाई, जैसे हमने आर्मी के दरवाजे खोल दिए, जैसे हमने एयरफोर्स में पायलट बनाए, हमने सीमा पर हमारी बेटियों को भेजा, सियाचिन में हमारी बेटियां जाकर के देश की रक्षा कर रही है। तो मैं एक साइकोलॉजिकल चेंज में सफल हुआ हूँ और देश की विकास यात्रा में महिलाओं की शक्ति एक अतिरिक्त शक्ति बनेगी और वो परिणाम को गति देगी।
और आज का दिन बहुत खास भी है, मदर्स डे है।
धन्यवाद, बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद,
शुक्रिया हमसे बात करने के लिए।
Well, this is the Prime Minister there speaking exclusively to Maria Shakeel. In fact, she also breaks down the Bihar story where the Prime Minister has been campaigning extensively. What's in store for the new Mahagathbandhan? Maria Shakeel with the latest.
The Prime Minister ensured the presence of Bihar Chief Minister and JDU President Nitish Kumar because these elections are being fought in an alliance way. It's an NDA which is fighting these elections. There is another constituent of NDA in Bihar, which is the LJP of Chirag Paswan, which is also contesting on a number of seats. But yes, the roadshow was about Prime Minister Narendra Modi and him alone because the response that was coming from the crowd was for him. But yes, Nitish was present and so was Ravi Shankar Prasad because he is the Member of Parliament from Patna and he is also the candidate of the BJP this time around. But you know, interestingly, we have seen that transitions which have happened. So every time there is an assembly election, Nitish Kumar does some kind of a U-turn. But when there is a Lok Sabha, he understands fully well that it is brand Narendra Modi which is sustaining NDA in Bihar. And even in assembly elections, and I would recall that for our viewers quickly, in 2020, that happened soon after the COVID lockdown, there was a lot of anger against Nitish Kumar. Nitish Kumar's party, JDU, became the party number three in those elections. But the BJP was party number two after Tejaswi Yadav's, RJD emerging as the party number one. But the larger message even in those times was that the Prime Minister Modi ensured food on the plates because of the scheme that he ran for 80 crore Indians.
So, well, phase four on Monday, you have 96 seats across 10 states going to polls. Big faces in the fray from Akhilesh Yadav, Mahua Moitra, Adhir Ranjan Chaudhary, Y.S. Sharmila, also Asaduddin Owaisi. So, it's a high stakes battle. We have our reporters spanned across the country. What really is in store for the regional satraps in the fray? Our reporters decode each state for us. Take a look.
People should come out in big numbers and vote. Last time, the record of Hyderabad has not been great. 45% was the voting in the 2019 parliament elections for Hyderabad and 48% in the assembly elections. Hopefully, this time they will do better. You are very right. Telangana, big stakes for all three parties. In fact, both the national parties dominating the scene, the BJP and the Congress hoping to actually benefit at the expense of the BRS, which was in fact the biggest party just less than 6 months ago. KCR was the tallest leader. We spoke about an election around KCR, but now we are talking about the survival of KCR and the BRS, whether the number of seats in the parliament elections, if he actually manages to win a few, then we'll be able to stop the tide of MLAs moving towards the Congress, splitting the party perhaps. But as you mentioned, the suspense-filled big election really is in Andhra Pradesh, 25 Lok Sabha seats. And even more exciting for all the Andhra Pradesh watchers is the 175 assembly seats. Interestingly, that is one state where neither national party is a big player, nor the Congress, nor the BJP. It's the three regional parties that are occupying the mind space of the people. The YSRCP led by Jagan Mohan Reddy and Telugu Desam and Pawan Kalyan. And whoever is going to win for the other, it's going to be a battle of survival if they lose this particular election.
So you have that contest, and like you said, a three-way contest in several seats. But in Asansol, for example, you have a contest between Shatrughan Sinha and SS Ahluwalia. Shatrughan Sinha, a well-known popular star, actor, also sitting MP. SS Ahluwalia was MP from the neighboring seat, Bardhaman Durgapur. He's now contesting from Asansol. In the neighboring seat, Bardhaman Durgapur, also you have Dilip Ghosh, who was the former BJP state president, widely credited with 18 seats for the BJP in 2019. On the other hand, you also have Kirti Azad, winner of the 1983 World Cup winning team, taking him on. Then you have Bahrampur, like I said, and you have Krishnanagar. And Krishnanagar, of course, is Mahua Moitra versus Amrita Roy, Krishnanagar royal family member. And also, let's not forget Birbhum, where this time around the TMC does not have Anubrata Mondal, the district president, to manage the elections for the party. So you have very interesting seats, you have very interesting faces in these elections who are contesting, and Asansol, Bahrampur, Birbhum, also you have the Bardhaman Durgapur, and all these seats going to polls is very, very interesting.
The BJP is trying to see Orissa as the new ground where the party would not only like to make political inroads but win more seats. Remember, Orissa, Bengal and Northeast, these three regions have been in BJP's plan of things in terms of maximizing their number of seats so that their seats increase. And therefore, Prime Minister Modi had led the campaign in Orissa targeting the BJD, which has been in power for 25 years, directly targeting Chief Minister Naveen Patnaik. And there has been a retort from Naveen Babu, as he's fondly called here. I am reporting right this moment from Bahrampur town, the silk city of Orissa. Behind me is a bustling city, but this is the fortress of the Janata Dal. This is the home district of Chief Minister Naveen Patnaik, the Ganjam district, and here in Bahrampur there is a close fight this time because of the turncoats. There have been a lot of turncoats who are contesting this time in different seats, and in Bahrampur you have Pradeep Panigrahi, who was once a former minister in BJD government, once a very close aide of Naveen Patnaik, now the BJP candidate, whereas BJD has given ticket to once a top BJP leader from Odisha, Bhrugu Bakshi Patra. So a close fight here.
All preparations are done. I'm at Srinagar's historic at Lal Chowk in Srinagar at Clock Tower, which is witness to what has Kashmir gone through for decades together. And it will be almost after 30 years when Srinagar will vote without the fear of violence or any boycott call. Here 24 candidates are in the fray, but the main contest is between PDP and National Conference. PDP has fielded Wahid Rahman Para, a man who was the person face of the BJP-PDP government's youth outreach program, face of that, then landed in jail under UAPA terror charges against a person who is a terror victim whose father was killed by militants in IED attack, Aga Ruhullah. So clearly, both actually talking about the same thing. Article 370, its abrogation is the central to the election campaigning here. BJP is not contesting the election. They are not contesting all the three seats at the valley, despite the fact BJP is saying that post-abrogation, they have brought peace in the valley. So before Srinagar would elect its new MP, one thing is clear, that it is going to leave behind its boycott legacy. And tomorrow, the first thing what is expected Srinagar would do is to defeat the boycott politics, because it was not serving any interest.
Looking at some other political news now, well, with an eye on Congress Citadel's top BJP leadership attacking the Gandhis, both in Raebareli and Amethi. In Raebareli, of course, it was Amit Shah versus Priyanka Gandhi. Take a look.
मैं बहन प्रियंका जी का भाषण सुन रहा था. उन्होंने कहा मैं मेरे परिवार से वोट मांगने आई हूं. लोकतंत्र के अंदर 5 साल तक यहां से चुन कर जाने के बाद सोनिया जी और इनका परिवार रायबरेली कितनी बार आया है भैया, बताओ तो जरा. मोदी जी ने विकास की बहार चलाई है, मगर ये परिवार यहां एक बाड़ लगाकर बैठा है. विकास को रायबरेली में घुसने नहीं देता है. ये बाड़ा एक बार तोड़ दो, रायबरेली जनपद को हम उत्तर प्रदेश में नंबर वन जनपद बनाएंगे, नंबर वन.
ये लोग कहते हैं फिर से सरकार बनाओगे तो संविधान बदल देंगे, संविधान बदल देंगे, आपके अधिकार, आपके आरक्षण खत्म हो जाएंगे. यही चाहते हैं ये लोग, चाहते कि सत्ता बनी रहे बस. अब आ गया है समय सबको बदलने का. अपना भविष्य अपने हाथों में लो, और हम सब हैं पुश्तों से आपके साथ खड़े हैं. दादी जी शहीद हुए जब आपकी सांसद थी, पिताजी खड़े हो गए वो शहीद हुए, माता जी खड़ी हो गई, आज उनका बेटा है आपके पास, उसके मन में आपके लिए श्रद्धा है. दिल लगा के काम करेंगे आपके लिए. उनको भारी बहुमत से जिताइए कि किसी के भय में मत आइए, डरिए मत।
Meanwhile, Smriti Irani also took on Rahul Gandhi in what was erstwhile a Congress bastion, Amethi. She said Rahul Gandhi first ran from Amethi to Wayanad and now to Raebareli. Take a look.
कि 20 तारीख को एक एक वोटर घर के बाहर जाकर पोलिंग बूथ पर जाएगा, अमेठी में कमल का बटन दबाएगा, फिर एक बार केंद्र में मोदी की सरकार देश का एक एक राष्ट्रभक्त बनाएगा। आज ये हुंकार यहाँ से जानी चाहिए।
So political temperatures on the rise. We'll take a short break now. News continues on the other side. Welcome back. Let's get your exclusive with Shashi Tharoor. He spoke to NDTV on the campaign trail in Mumbai. Take a look.
We've got senior Congress leader Shashi Tharoor with us. Sir, welcome to Mumbai. You were here to become a part of the rally and also seek votes for the Mahavikas Aghadi. What does the ground look like for Mahavikas Aghadi?
Incredibly positive. I mean, yesterday I did two constituencies in Bombay city, Mumbai city. And this morning I went into a third one and did an interactive session with about 350 people. I have to say, in each place, the concerns I saw, the passion I saw, the enthusiasm I saw, leaves me feeling very upbeat and very positive. I think we're heading for a very big victory in Maharashtra.
Sir, Narendra Modi's invitation for Sharad Pawar to join the BJP, how do you think that is going to affect, if he ever does, the Mahavikas Aghadi?
First of all, he's never going to do it, because obviously this is a sign of Mr. Modi's failure and Mr. Modi's desperation. He can see the same signs we are seeing. He can see there is no future for the BJP. They're trying to get allies wherever they can. They've been humiliatingly spurned by the Akali Dal in Punjab, by the BJD in Odisha. They have looking for everyone they can get, because they know they cannot manage. They never come close to a majority without getting new allies. But why would anyone want to oblige them? Mr. Pawar's party was broken by Mr. Modi's party. Do you think he's going to be grateful and go and join them? Not at all. As far as I'm concerned, we have commonalities of ideology and of conviction and of principle, and it's on that basis that we'll move forward.
Sir, today in an interview to Samana, Uddhav Thackeray has compared Mr. Modi to Aurangzeb. Talking about secularism here, don't you think that here somewhere there are efforts of either downgrading Aurangzeb or in a way making some remarks that won't go with the party?
No, I don't want to comment on other people's comments. I will certainly say that Mr. Modi's misrule over the last 10 years, from demonetization to the botched rollout of GST, to the unemployment, to the high inflation, to the failure to double farmers' incomes, to the mistreatment of labor, you go down the list. There is nothing but a sorry track record of failure on the part of Mr. Modi and the BJP government. To my mind, that is the real issue facing the nation. Do we want to give these people a third chance to fail again? Do they deserve another opportunity? And the answer very clearly is no.
And moving now to the big capital showdown. Well, Arvind Kejriwal has hit the ground running and he doubled down on his Prime Minister retirement remark. In fact, he also released his own guarantees as a counter to Modi's guarantees. Take a look.
Ek taraf hai Modi ki guarantee, ek taraf hai Kejriwal ki guarantee. Modi ki guarantee ka hum dekh chuke hain ki Modi ki guarantee yakeen karne ka layak nahi hai. Aur ab to agli saal chuki Modi ji retire honge, to unki retirement ke baad Modi ki guarantee kaun puri karega, iska bhi koi वो नहीं है. और केजरीवाल की गारंटी, केजरीवाल यही है, कहीं नहीं जा रहा. तो केजरीवाल की गारंटी पूरी करने की गारंटी केजरीवाल लेता है.
And that's all the time that we have on the show from all of us here. Goodbye.